Good afternoon to one and all. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed the point is that the types of DC generator. Okay, so types of DC generator we have already discussed. So there are main three types of DC generator according to the how the field it can be excited or field it can be developed. So according to this, there are first one type is nothing but PMDC generator. Second one is that separately excited DC generator, and third one is nothing but self excited DC generator. Okay, so in a separately excited DC generator, again we have discussed that the field it can be excited by using a separate DC source or external DC source. We are able to excite the field of that type of DC generator. Permanent magnet DC generator, that is in that for the developing the field, that is magnetic field, we are using a permanent magnet. And the third one type is that the self excited DC generator. So the self excited DC generator is that the field it can be developed by the current generated by generated itself, so that it is called as self excited DC generator. Again, the self excited DC generator, it is having an three types. In that first one, these three types, it is based upon how the field winding it can be connected with that of armature winding. Okay, according to there are three types. First one type is that the shunt self excited generator or the shunt wound self excited generator. In that, the shunt field winding of the generator, it can be connected in a parallel with that of armature winding. Armature winding cha parallel madhe javles field winding connect kele asel, then we can call it as a shunt field generator, or it may be shunt wound generator. Then next one is that the series wound generator. In case of series wound generator, the field winding of the DC machine or the DC generator, it can be connected in a series with that of armature winding. Javales armature winding cha series madhe connect kele asel, then we are calling it as a series wound DC generator. And okay, and next one is nothing but the compound wound DC generator. We have already discussed this one. Again, the compound wound DC generator is that the compound wound DC generator, in that the both winding like series field winding as well as shunt field winding, it is connected. So in case of series field and shunt field winding, that is compound generator, the one of the winding having an maximum resistance, that is high resistance, and one of the winding having a low resistance, that is minimum resistance. So series field winding having a low resistance, and it is shunt field winding, it is having a high resistance. Okay, it is having a high resistance. Again, there are two types. If the flux produced by series field winding, if it is adds with that of shunt field winding, that is shunt field, series field, if it is adds with that of shunt field, then it is called as a cumulatively compounded generator. This one is already discussed. Okay, this is called as cumulatively compounded generator. And if the series field or the field produced by series field winding, if it is opposes to that of shunt field, then it is called as differentially compounded generator. Okay, differentially compounded generator. So the connection for that, and according to connection, there are two types, that is short shunt and long shunt. If the armature of the DC generator, it is connected in parallel with that of only shunt field winding, then it is called as short shunt compound generator. And if the armature or the shunt field winding, it is connected in parallel with that of armature plus series field winding, then it is called as long shunt compound generator. So this figure, this one figure, it is nothing but for long shunt compound generator. this one figure, it is nothing but Schwarzian compound generator. So this part we have already covered in the previous lecture. We have already done the detailed discussion related to these types of DC machine. Now today we will discuss about the next one point of this unit, is that the characteristics of DC generator. Characteristics of DC generator. Now the characteristics, it is very important. That means what is mean by characteristics, we will discuss first what is mean by characteristics, then which are the types of different types of characteristics which are understood in case of DC generator. So generator characteristics, do you know that the characteristics is nothing but it gives an relation between two quantity. What is mean by characteristics? It gives and the relation between two quantity or the two parameter. Suppose one parameter is plotted on one axis. Here V is plotted on this axis, and suppose I is plotted on this axis, and it gives and one relation, like suppose it gives and the graph, it will be like this. Okay, it gives and a graph, it will be like this. That means it will show that there is a linear relationship between these two parameter. Ya don parameter madhe kay ahe, linear relationship hai. So that means the characteristics it gives and relation between the characteristics, it will gives and a relation between the two parameter. Don parameter cha relation characteristics define kele asel, or it is plotted in the form of graph. These types of graphical representation, we can call it as a characteristics. Okay, so characteristics is nothing but there is a graphical representation between two parameters. So graphical representation between either terminal voltage and the terminal current, or it is the graphical representation between the excitation of the generator, it is the graphical representation between the load of the generator. Okay, that means there are some different parameter. We can plot any two parameter with respect to that, and then plot one graph or one plot a characteristics. This is nothing but characteristics of DC generator. Now why this characteristics is important? Because this characteristics, it is having an great importance or it is helpful while judging a one type of generator. कुठलेही जनरेटर आपल्याला जज करायचे आहे, अँड वी वॉन्ट टू सिलेक्ट दॅट जनरेटर फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर ऍप्लिकेशन. सो व्हाइल सिलेक्टिंग अ जनरेटर फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर पर्पज ऑर द पर्टिक्युलर ऍप्लिकेशन, वी नीड टू अनालाइज द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑर वी नीड टू अंडरस्टँड द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सी, द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर जजिंग द suitability of the generator for a particular application. That means suppose I want to select one generator for a one particular application, whether this generator is suitable for that application, this can be decided by understanding or by analyzing the characteristics. Okay, so that the characteristics, it is very important in case of generator as well as in case of machine. Okay, so see, the characteristics is nothing but it is a one type of relation, or it is this relation, it can be plotted in the form of graph, so that we can call it as a characteristics. So the characteristics, it is important to judge the performance of the machine, to judge the behavior of the machine, as well as to understand the performance, like relationship of that machine. Either it may be voltage to current relation, either it may be speed to voltage relation, either it may be output to that of input relation, okay, or it may be efficiency. So this parameter, it can be understood by analyzing or by judging the characteristics. Getting? Lakshya dala ka characteristics? Why? What is mean by characteristics in case of DC generator? We will see the different characteristics in case of DC generator. Whether you understand the what is mean by characteristics? Give me reply. Characteristics. Hello. whether you are understood or not, what is meant by characteristics? Yes. See, the characteristics, it is important, or it gives a relation between a two parameter. Okay, it gives a relation between a two parameter. This relationship, it is plotted in the form of graph, so that we can call it as a characteristics. So the characteristics, it is having a great importance, or it is nothing but it is an importance while judging the suitability of the generator, or whether this generator is suitable for a particular type of application or the particular purpose. Okay, now see, in case of generator, or it may be in case of DC machine, this DC machine or the DC generator, it is operated in the fixed speed. Do you know that the prime mover is attached to that of generator? Generator la prime mover attached asel. So the prime mover, it can be rotated. Practically, it is in the constant value because there are the speed governor, it can be connected. Okay, there are speed governor system, or the speed governor, it can be used to control the speed. So the speed of DC machine, which is operated as a generator, it is fixed by using a prime mover. That means prime mover is attached so that speed of the generator, it is constant. Okay, and this generator or this prime mover, it is equipped with that of speed governor. He je kai generator asel, this generator, it can be equipped with that of prime mover. Prime mover cha use karun ani speed governor cha use karun te generator kai kelle asel, equipped kelle asel. Okay, so this governor or the speed governor, it will be makes the speed of generator practically constant. Generator cha speed kai asel, practically constant. Now if the speed of the generator, it will be constant, jyavle generator cha speed constant asel, at that situation we want to understand the performance of that generator, in the form of excitation, in the form of terminal voltage, as well as in the form of load condition. That means it gives an relation between some excitation, it gives an relation between the terminal voltage, as well as it gives an relation between the load. That means when the input or the primary speed of the generator, it will be constant. And this relation, if it is exhibited in the form of graph, he je kai relation asel, if it is exhibited in the form of graph, so these types of graph, it is known as generator characteristics. These types of graph, whichever plotted against the two parameter, so this graph, it is called as characteristics of that type of generator or the characteristics of DC generator. Okay, and these characteristics, it is having an importance to judge the behavior of the generator. And after judging the behavior of the generator, we are able to analyze which generator is suitable for that particular application. म्हणजे माझे एखादा पर्टिक्युलर ऍप्लिकेशन असेल, त्या ऍप्लिकेशन साठी विच जनरेटर इज सुटेबल, दिस कॅन बी अनालाइज्ड और दिस कॅन बी अंडरस्टूड बाय युजिंग द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, आय थिंक यू पीपल नो दॅट इफ यू आर सिलेक्टिंग वन ऑफ द डीसी मशीन फॉर युअर ऍप्लिकेशन, आय एम टेकिंग हिअर एक्झाम्पल फॉर डीसी मोटर, और इट मे बी इंडक्शन मोटर विच इज सिलेक्टेड फॉर युअर ऍग्रीकल्चर पर्पज. आपण जी शेतीपंपाची मोटर सिलेक्ट करतो, सो फॉर दॅट मशीन, वाईल सिलेक्टिंग दॅट मशीन, वी आर अनालायझिंग दिअर कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. दॅट मीन्स वी आर अनालायझिंग ऑर सीईंग दिअर नेम प्लेट. ऑन दॅट नेम प्लेट देअर आर ऑल रेटिंग्स आर प्रोव्हाइडेड, एज वेल एज इफिशियन्सी ऑफ द मशीन इट विल बी. हॅलो, ओके, सी, in that nameplate the efficiency of the machine, it can be denoted, the machine chi efficiency denote kelle asel. So according to efficiency is nothing but it is the ratio of output divided by input, or it gives an relation between output to input. That means at this much of input, what is the output of that machine? So according to seeing the efficiency, we are able to select that machine. So similarly, the characteristics is important while selecting a DC generator for a particular application or for a particular purpose of application. Okay, so that means it gives an behavior of that generator or that machine. त्या मशीनचं जे काही बिहेवियर असेल एक डिफरंट टाईपच्या कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स त्याच्यामधलं जे काही बिहेवियर असेल आयदर इट मे बी इलेक्ट्रिकल बिहेवियर आयदर इट मे बी मेकॅनिकल बिहेवियर दॅट मीन्स देअर आर सम टाईप्स ऑफ कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स लाईक इलेक्ट्रिकल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर डिफरंट मेकॅनिकल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर डिफरंट देन मॅग्नेटिक कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर ऑल्सो डिफरंट ओके सो दिस बिहेवियर ऑफ द मशीन इट कॅन बी अंडरस्टूड बाय सीईंग ऑर बाय अंडरस्टँडिंग द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स नाउ देअर आर three most important characteristics of curve of a DC generator. So in case of DC generator, there are three important characteristics to analyze. आपल्याला तीन important characteristics काय करायचे आहेत analyze करायचे आहेत okay so we want to understand just one minute okay see there are three most important characteristics is there or the characteristics curve is there so we will discuss one by one so see the three important characteristics first one is nothing but the no load characteristics so no load characteristics this types of characteristics it is called as occ characteristics that means open circuit characteristics or it is called as magnetic characteristics okay see no load characteristics that is also called as occ characteristics or it is also called as magnetic characteristics or it means nothing but magnetization characteristics okay first one characteristics of the dc generator it is nothing but no load characteristics ahe open circuit characteristics manto apan tela as well as magnetization characteristics okay this characteristics it gives and relation between e0 and if okay this characteristics it gives and relation between e0 and if so see it shows that the relation between the no load generated emf in the armature that is e0 represent that the generated emf in the armature at no load condition that is e0 and the field or the exciting current if field current or the exciting current if so he baga relation kashashi ahe e0 versus if this is characteristics is nothing but no load characteristics or it is called as occ characteristics so it is just the magnetization curve for the material of the electromagnet so those electromagnetic material it can be used so this characteristics it gives that the magnetization curve for that material that material sa magnetization curve it will be shown by this characteristics now its shape is practically the same for all types of generator whether it is separately excited generator or it is self excited generator ya characteristic cha jo kai shape asel so this shape it is same for all types of generator whether it is separately excited generator or it is self excited generator mang te separately excited generator asel as well as self excited generator asel mhanje dc shunt generator asel DC series असेल DC compound असेल as well as separately excited for all types of generator the shape for no load saturation characteristics it is same okay getting no load saturation characteristics or the occ characteristics the shape remains same for all types of generator all of you keep in mind okay and this curve it is plotted against no load induced emf in the armature or the no load generated emf in the armature versus the exciting current or the field current of the generator that is if when the speed of the machine it will be kept constant jyavele speed machine cha apan fix thevtoy or the speed machine cha speed je ahe te constant thevtoy by using a prime mover then we can plotting this curve, that is no load saturation characteristics. Getting Lakshadala no load saturation curve, we will discuss in the detail how it will be plotted and how it's shape. Hey Lakshadala ka tumhala, hello, give me reply.
Yes sir.
Okay, now this one is the first characteristics. Second characteristics is that the internal characteristics. Second one characteristics, it is called as internal, or it is also called as total characteristics. Tell internal characteristics, or it is nothing but it is called as a total characteristics. See, it gives the relation between the induced EMF E, which is actually induced in the armature, and the armature current. See, it shows that the curve, or it gives a relation between the generated EMF at load condition. ज्यावेळेस आपण काहीतरी जनरेटर वरती लोड पुट करतोय, at that situation चा induced EMF, that is E, बघा डिफरन्स बघा याच्यामध्ये, इथे E zero रिप्रेझेंट केलेलं आहे, that means induced EMF at no load condition, and induced EMF at some of the load condition versus armature current, that is versus Ia. Okay, so see the internal characteristics, or it is called as total characteristics of the DC generator. It gives a relation between the induced EMF E at a load condition versus the armature current Ia. Armature current. It gives a relation between the EMF E actually induced in the armature and the armature current of the DC generator. DC generator cha armature current, yacha je kay relation asel, this is called as internal characteristics, or it is also called as total characteristics of DC machine. It is also called as the total characteristics of a DC machine. Okay, so that means induced EMF E at load condition, always it is greater than that of no load condition, because there are some of the armature reaction effect as well as armature drop, it can be included. Armature drop and armature reaction effect mula jo ka EMF induce hoto hai. So this EMF at load condition, it is less than that of EMF induced at no load condition. No load condition cha jo ka EMF asel, tyachyapeksha लोड कंडिशनचा ईएमएफ हा काय असेल, लेस असेल. अँड देन थर्ड वन कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज दॅट द एक्सटर्नल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. सो एक्सटर्नल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डीसी जनरेटर इज दॅट, एक्सटर्नल कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज नथिंग बट इट गिव्ज अँड रिलेशन बिटवीन द टर्मिनल व्होल्टेज व्ही ॲट द आउटपुट साईड अँड द लोड करंट आय एल. सो सी, इट गिव्ज द रिलेशन बिटवीन the terminal voltage VL and the load current IL. Terminal voltage VL and load current IL cha je ka relation asel, so this characteristics, it is called as external characteristics, or sometimes this characteristics it called as voltage regulation curve. This characteristics is called as voltage regulation curve. Okay, see, the value of VL, that means we have already discussed the that means voltage equation in case of each and every machine, that is voltage equation in case of DC shunt generator, voltage equation in case of DC series generator. Okay, we have already derived this equation. So this characteristics, this characteristics, the value of VL, that is load voltage, this VL, it is less than that of induced EMF at no load condition, because this VL, it can be obtained by subtracting Ia array drop from the corresponding value of E. Okay, ji ka induced EMF chi value asel, so from that value of induced EMF E, if we are subtracting the armature voltage drop, that is Ia array, then we will get the value of E. We have write the equation in the in case of DC shunt generator, VL is equals to VL, it is equals to EG minus IA array. आपण हे ऑलरेडी व्होल्टेज इक्वेशन लिहिलेलं आहे, That means if we subtract the IERA from the induced EMF at no load condition EZ, then we will get the value of EL. And this is a great importance in judging the suitability of a generator for a particular application. So these three characteristics, or the these three types of characteristics, it is very much important to judge the generator for a suitable application. Ek suitable application sathi jar generator aplyala purchase karayche, or it may be generator select karayche, for selecting the generator for a suitable application or the particular application, we want to judge these characteristics. We want to judge these characteristics, or we want to understand these characteristics. Okay. Now we will see one by one characteristics. In that first one characteristic, that is no load saturation characteristics, or the open circuit characteristic, that is OCC curve. Okay. So we will discuss one by one. Now, okay, in that first one, the open circuit characteristics are the open circuit characteristics of a DC generator. Okay, so for that, while deriving these characteristics, we have taken here separately excited generator. I have told one sentence in the previously, that is OCC characteristics for all types of generator, it will be same. OCC characteristics ka hai, all types cha generator chi ka hai se, same as same. Okay. Now see, we will derive the open circuit characteristics. Here it is figure. In that OCC curve, it can be shown. But I will firstly, how it will be constructed, that means how this characteristics it can be conducted and how the graph it can be plotted, I will tell first, then I will explain the characteristics. See, the open circuited characteristics of a DC generator, open circuited characteristics of a DC generator, it will gives the relation between the no load induced EMF, no load induced EMF, that is E0, versus field current IF. E0 versus field current IF. Here relation dakavte. See here. Here it is E0 versus field current IF is there. That is field current IF. So field current IF, it can be plotted on x-axis, and the no load induced EMF, it can be plotted on y-axis. And we have drawn one characteristics. So this characteristics is nothing but open circuit characteristics. Now, how this characteristics it will be got? See. See, whether it is in case of separately excited generator or it is in case of self-excited generator, so this procedure it will be same. See here, here we have considered that the separately excited generator. So separately excited generator, the meaning of that is nothing but the field winding, it can be developed by applying some of the external DC source. Ek external DC voltage source apply karun field winding kai kelne. That means field winding excite killle, so that we can call it as a separately excited. If we consider the self excited generator, again the procedure is same. Suppose we have considered the self excited generator, first step is that the field winding of the self excited generator, it is disconnected from the supply and it is connected separately by using a external DC source. Okay. Manun, so that its characteristics it will be same. Kayachi characteristics same hai baga. So while deriving these characteristics, we want to excite the field by using the separate voltage source. Ek separate voltage source sa use karun aplyala characteristic chi voltage source sa use karun hi field winding kay karayche, excite karayche. Mag separately excited asel tar same construction in for self excited generator. Self excited generator is a construction cast. Here it is shunt field winding. This one is the armature of the DC generator, and this will be provided to that of load. Yeah, side like I said, load. I said, see, yachamade kai steps asel. This field winding of the DC generator, it is disconnected from the supply. Yachakodun disconnect keli jail, manje yacha connection ite disconnect keli jail. And this can be connected to a external DC supply. एक एक्सटर्नल डीसी सप्लायला काय केलं असेल, कनेक्ट केलं. सो इफ द फील्ड वाइंडिंग इट इज कनेक्टेड इन एक्सटर्नल डीसी सप्लाय, इन एक्सटर्नल डीसी सप्लाय, दैट मीन्स इट इज सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड. ओके, सो सी, इफ द फील्ड वाइंडिंग इट इज डिस्कनेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सप्लाय एंड इट इज कनेक्टेड बाय यूजिंग अ सेपरेट डीसी सोर्स, सेपरेट डीसी सोर्स, एंड दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इट विल बी प्लॉटेड लाइक दिस. ही जी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स असेल, जे जनरेटर आहे त्याला आपल्याला पहिल्यांदा सेपरेटली एक्साइटेड करायचं, म्हणजे एक्साइटेशनला सेपरेट डीसी सोर्स यूज करणार. वाईल युझिंग द सेपरेट डीसी सोर्स फॉर द एक्साइटेशन वी आर एबल टू डिटरमाइन द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. ओके, नाउ द जनरेटर, ऍज वी नो दॅट द प्राइम मूवर इट इज रनिंग ऍट अ कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड, सो द जनरेटर इट इज रन ऍट अ फिक्स्ड स्पीड. ओके, ऑर इट मे बी अ कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड ऑर द नॉर्मल स्पीड. जनरेटर जे आहे ते एका कॉन्स्टंट स्पीडला काय केलं जातं, रन केलं जातं. ओके, इफ द जनरेटर इट इज रनिंग ऍट अ कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड, दॅट इज बाय युझिंग अ प्राइम मूवर द स्पीड ऑफ द जनरेटर इट विल बी केप्ट कॉन्स्टंट. ज्यावेळी जनरेटरचं स्पीड आपण कॉन्स्टंट केप्ट करतोय, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन द फील्ड करंट ऑफ द जनरेटर, जनरेटरचा फील्ड करंट, इट कॅन बी इन्क्रीज्ड फ्रॉम इट्स झिरो व्हॅल्यू टू द मॅक्झिमम व्हॅल्यू बाय स्टेप सी इन हियर द कन्स्ट्रक्शन. इफ द फील्ड वाइंडिंग इट कॅन बी कनेक्टेड सेपरेटली विथ दॅट ऑफ डीसी सोर्स, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन वन ऑफ द ॲमिटर इट कॅन बी कनेक्टेड इन सिरीज विथ दॅट ऑफ फील्ड वाइंडिंग, अँड वन ऑफ द रिओस्टॅट इट कॅन बी कनेक्टेड अगेन इन सिरीज विथ दॅट ऑफ फील्ड वाइंडिंग. फील्ड वाइंडिंगच्या सिरीजमध्ये काय करतोय आपण, रिओस्टॅट कनेक्ट करतोय फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ करंट विच इज फ्लोईंग थ्रू द फील्ड वाइंडिंग. वी आर कनेक्टिंग हिअर वन ऑफ द ॲमिटर, याच्यामध्ये एक ॲमिटर कनेक्ट करतोय. नाउ टू मेजर द वोल्टेज इंड्यूस्ड ऍट नो लोड कंडिशन, हिअर इट इज ऍट द आउटपुट साइड, इट इज केप्ट ओपन सर्क्युटेड अँड वन ऑफ द वोल्टमीटर इज कनेक्टेड टू मेजर द इंड्यूस्ड EMF, दॅट इज वोल्टेज E0. एक वोल्टेज मेजर करण्यासाठी एक वोल्टमीटर आपण काय करतोय, ओपन सर्क्युटेड टर्मिनलला कनेक्ट करतोय. ओके, सो दिस इज द कन्स्ट्रक्शन ऑर द डायग्राम फॉर द फॉर कंडक्टिंग अँड OCC टेस्ट, ऑर इट मे बी वाईल डिरायव्हिंग द ओपन सर्क्युट कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. वी वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म द प्रॅक्टिकल ऑन द सेम पॉईंट, या पॉईंटवरचं प्रॅक्टिकल परफॉर्म करायचंय, अँड वी वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टँड द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑल्सो, याच्यावरून आपल्याला कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स पण अंडरस्टँड करू. नाउ इफ द स्पीड ऑफ द जनरेटर इट इज कॉन्स्टंट, ज्यावेळेस जनरेटरचं स्पीड कॉन्स्टंट आहे, सपोज जनरेटर इट इज रनिंग ऍट अ कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड ऑफ 1500 रिव्होल्यूशन पर मिनिट, जनरेटर एक 1500 RPMला, म्हणजे त्याच्या रेटेड RPMला काय होते, रन होते. वेन द जनरेटर इट कॅन बी रनिंग विथ द कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड, दॅट इज रनिंग इट्स अ रेटेड स्पीड ऑर इट मे बी कॉन्स्टंट स्पीड, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन द फील्ड करंट ऑफ द मशीन, that is IF, it can be increased gradually from its zero value to the maximum value. Okay, so ha jo kai field current asel itla ha field current that means by excitation and by varying this rheostat, ha rheostat initially kept it at maximum position, ha rheostat apan maximum position la kept karna, by reducing the value of resistance the current flowing through that field winding it is increased gradually, त्याच्यामधून फ्लो होणारा करंट काय होईल, इन्क्रीज ग्रॅज्युअली इन द स्टेप बाय स्टेप ऑर इट मे बी इन स्टेप वाईज व्हॅल्यू, अँड द ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ फील्ड करंट IF अँड ऑल्सो ऍट अ पर्टिक्युलर स्टेप द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड EMF E0 इट कॅन बी नोटेड. त्यावेळेस इंड्यूस्ड EMF E0 आणि फील्ड करंटची व्हॅल्यू काय करायची, नोट डाऊन करून घ्यायची. नाउ इफ द व्हॅल्यू आर नोटेड डाऊन and if this point it can be joined we are getting one of the characteristics, javale se point je ahe this point while drawing the characteristics or while conducting these types of test and when we are taking the reading and if the graph it can be plotted, so E0 versus IF graph, so at that situation we will get the one characteristics, that is these types of characteristics, it is nothing but the open circuited characteristics. Okay, it is nothing but the open circuited characteristics, OCC characteristics, or it is also called as no load saturation curve, or it is also called as the magnetization curve or magnetization characteristics. Tala magnetization characteristics manto apan, as well as it is also called as no load characteristics, or it is called as the open circuit characteristic, that is OCC characteristics. Okay, now some of the conclusion it can be getting, some of the conclusion it can be getting. See here, these characteristics, see these characteristics, it will be started from somewhat the here point, from this point. Couldn't start the characteristics, whether the characteristics is starting from zero or it may be some point. Couldn't start the bagadana.
Some point.
Huh, whether this characteristics, it can be started from some of the point. Because of this, that means reason behind this, before exciting field winding, that's a meaning kaya hote baga. See here. It will be started from some value, that means at a zero value of field current, there are some of the induced EMF is present, right? That's a meaning kaya jala, the characteristics itun start jali. याचा अर्थ काय झालं, ऍट अ झिरो व्हॅल्यू ऑफ फील्ड करंट, ज्यावेळेस फील्ड करंट झिरो आहे, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन देअर आर सम ऑफ द इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इज प्रेझेंट. एवढा जो काय ईएमएफ असेल, सो दिस इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट विल बी प्रेझेंट ऍट अ झिरो व्हॅल्यू ऑफ फील्ड करंट. राईट, राईट नो? हॅलो, लक्ष देते का?
येस सर.
दॅट मीन्स बिफोर एक्साइटिंग द फील्ड वाइंडिंग, there are some of the induced EMF, it will be present in case of DC generator. All of you keep this point in mind. So see, before exciting the field current or the before exciting the field winding, manje field winding excite karnyacha agodar, manje excite karnyacha agodar, meaning of that, javeles field current zero ahe, at that situation, there are some of the induced EMF in the generator. या जनरेटर मध्ये इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ आहे काहीतरी, सो दिस इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट विल बी रिप्रेझेंटेड हियर. सो दिस इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट इज ड्यू टू द, हा जो काय इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ असेल, द रिझन बिहाइंड इट, दिस इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट इज ड्यू टू द रेसिडुअल मॅग्नेटिझम प्रेझेंट इन द पोल बिफोर एक्साइटिंग द फील्ड वाइंडिंग. बघा, फील्ड वाइंडिंग एक्साइट करण्याच्या अगोदर जनरेटर मध्ये काहीतरी इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ आहे. मी सेल्फ एक्साइटेड जनरेटरचा कन्सेप्ट सांगताना सांगितलं होतं, बिफोर एक्साइटिंग द फील्ड वाइंडिंग देअर आर सम ऑफ द रेसिडुअल मॅग्नेटिझम इट विल बी प्रेझेंट इन द फील्ड पोल. फील्ड पोल मध्ये काहीतरी रेसिडुअल मॅग्नेटिझम प्रेझेंट आहे, सो ड्यू टू दॅट रेसिडुअल मॅग्नेटिझम सम ऑफ द ईएमएफ ऑर द सम ऑफ द इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट विल बी प्रेझेंट बिफोर एक्साइटिंग द फील्ड वाइंडिंग. फील्ड वाइंडिंग एक्साइट होण्याच्या अगोदर त्याच्यामध्ये काहीतरी इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ काय आहे, प्रेझेंट आहे. सपोज आय हॅव रिप्रेझेंटेड दिस ग्राफ ओ टू ए, सो दिस ग्राफ शोज दॅट द इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ ऑफ द जनरेटर बिफोर एक्साइटिंग द फील्ड वाइंडिंग. नाऊ आफ्टर दॅट पॉइंट ए, इफ द फील्ड करंट इज इन्क्रीजेस, ज्यावेळेस आपण हा फील्ड करंट इन्क्रीज करू, म्हणजे आपण फील्ड वाइंडिंग एक्साइट केलेले, इफ वी इन्क्रीज द फील्ड करंट बाय रिड्युसिंग द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टन्स, सो ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर इक्वेशन, दॅट इज इजी, इट इज इक्वल्स टू 5PNZ / 60A. So these are the sum of the constant and the equation becomes Eg is directly proportional to the phi into N. Eg is directly proportional to phi into N. So I am representing K phi into N. Okay. Now, if the current increases, the speed of the generator, it is constant. We have kept constant initially. Pahilyanda apan constant kept kelle. So that suppose it is 1500 RPM. And we are increasing the field current. Field current increase karatoy apan gradually. So if the field current, it can be increases gradually, then the flux increases gradually. And if the flux increases gradually, at that situation, the induced EMF, it will be increases gradually. That is Eg kay hotoy? Increase hotoy. easy, it will be increases gradually up to some of the point. Suppose here the point, it can be represented like a D point. So that means the when the field current, it will be increases, field current, it will be increases. And when the field current increases according to the relation, EG is directly proportional to K phi n. Speed of the machine, it will be constant. Machine's speed constant. And if we are increasing the current, so the induced EMF, it will be increases gradually. That means there is a linear relationship between the field current and induced EMF. Induced EMF and field current made linear relationship. Okay, because the reluctance of the iron path at that point, it is negligible. Javales relationship made iron path ja jo kai reluctance asel, it is also we are neglecting, and also we are maintaining the air gap reluctance is constant. Air gap reluctance, it is also constant. For that reason, it gives an linear relationship up to point D. See, curve kasa parat divide hote 0 to A, there are some of the induced EMF, it will be present before exciting the field winding due to the residual magnetism, so that the curve at a zero value of field current, there are some of the induced EMF is present. After this point A, if the field current increases, the induced EMF, it will be increases, and it gives an linear relationship. Yacha je kai relationship asel, so this gives an linear relationship. Okay, it will gives an linear relationship because of the iron path reluctance, it is negligible. Also, we are maintaining the flux, we are maintaining the reluctance in the air gap, it is also constant. Air gap madla reluctance pan apan constant maintain karte, as well as je kai iron core asel, so iron core reluctance, it is not taken into account or it is negligible. Now when the reluctance of the iron core, it will be taken into account, also the air gap flux, it is not constant, and the armature reaction effect, it is taken into account. Javeles armature reaction taken into account, as well as reluctance of the air gap, it is taken into account or the comes into picture. At that situation, because of the higher flux density, त्याची जी काय फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी असेल, सो ड्यू टू द हायर फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी दिस कर्व, इट विल बी डेविएट्स फ्रॉम द इट्स लिनियर रिलेशनशिप. लिनियर रिलेशनशिप पासून तो कर्व काय होतो, डेविएट होतो, म्हणजे इट्स पोझिशन इट विल बी चेंज. तो लिनियर रिलेशनशिप मेंटेन करत नाही, समवॉट इट विल बी कर्व्स ऑर इट मे बी समवॉट इट विल बी बेंड्स. तो काय विल बेंड, विल वेन द फील्ड करंट इट विल बी इन्क्रीजेस. ज्या वेळेस फील्ड करंट इन्क्रीज करतोय, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन the induced EMF relation, it will be deviates its linear relationship. त्याचं जी काय लिनियर रिलेशनशिप असेल ती काय होते, डेविएट होते अप टू पॉइंट बी. ओके, अप टू पॉइंट बी अँड आफ्टर पॉइंट बी, अँड आफ्टर पॉइंट बी देअर इज अ मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशन, इट विल बी हॅपन. ओके, आफ्टर पॉइंट बी there is a magnetic saturation, it will be happen. That means at the value of A, it the A chi value, after that if again we increase the current, there is a magnetic saturation, it will be happen. And again if we increase the value of current, then the induced EMF, it becomes constant. Okay, induced EMF, it becomes constant after the magnetic saturation, it will be happen. म्हणजे मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशन झाल्यानंतर हा कर्व काय होतोय, एक कॉन्स्टंट रिलेशनशिप मेंटेन करतोय. म्हणजे कितीही करंट इनक्रीज केला, आय हॅव टेल द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशन, मी मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशनचा कन्सेप्ट ऑलरेडी तुम्हाला सांगितलेलं आहे. ऍट वन पॉइंट ऑर ऍट वन पोझिशन इफ वी इनक्रीज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ वन पॅरामीटर, देन अदर पॅरामीटर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट. Okay, other parameter remains constant. I have given one example, the sugar, it can be dissolved in the water, म्हणजे साखर पाण्यामध्ये विरघळते, त्याचं एक एक्झाम्पल दिलं होतं. एका स्टेजला साखर पाण्यामध्ये विरघळत नाहीये. ओके, दॅट मीन्स द मॅग्नेटिक, दॅट मीन्स द सॅच्युरेशन, इट विल बी हॅपन. अँड इन केस ऑफ दिस जनरेटर, there is a magnetic saturation will be happen after the current A. इथे करंट ए दाखवलेला आहे. सो आफ्टर द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस करंट इफ वी अगेन इनक्रीज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ करंट, आपण परत किती जरी करंटची व्हॅल्यू इनक्रीज केली द तर जो काय इंड्यूस्ड ई एम एफ असेल इट विल बी कॉन्स्टंट. इंड्यूस्ड ई एम एफ इट विल बी कॉन्स्टंट. ओके, सो दिस टाइप्स ऑफ कर अँड दिस टाइप्स ऑफ कर इट इज कॉल्ड एज ओपन सर्क्युट कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, दॅट इज ओ सी सी, एज वेल एज इट इज कॉल्ड एज नो लोड कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, no load curve, or it may be no load characteristics, or it is called as magnetization characteristics of DC machine or DC generator. And these characteristics, it is same for all types of generator, whether it is self excited generator, whether it is separately excited generator, or it may be a permanent magnet DC generator. Okay, so all types of characteristics, all types of DC generator, this characteristics it is remains same. Okay, see this characteristics is divided into some part, kai part madhe divide zalle baga, from 0 to A this is one part, from A to D this is another one part, from D to B it is nothing but another one part, and from B to after that it is another one part. That means this characteristics it is divided into four part madhe divide zalle, from 0 to A there is some of the induced emf in the dc generator before exciting the field winding, due to the residual magnetism or the residual flux it will be present in the poles of the dc generator. After a to after the point of a, if the field current it will be increases, the induced emf it will be increases, and it gives an linear relationship. The linear relationship gives, then again it gives an linear relationship due to the iron core reluctance, it will be negligible, it will not taken into account. Also the air gap reluctance, it is also constant. If the air gap reluctance and the iron core reluctance, if it is taken into account, that means after point D this curve it will be deviates from its linear relationship. Ha jo kai curve asel tacha linear relationship pasun kay hoto, deviates hoto. Okay, and after point B if we again increase the value of field current, jar apan field current chi value again increase keli, then the induced emf it is remains constant because of the saturation it will be happen, and due to the saturation, that is due to the magnetic saturation, if we increase the value of current, then the induced emf of that of generator it is constant. Generator cha jo kai induced emf asel ha constant asel. Okay, getting he lakshat ala ka? Is there any doubt? Kunala kai doubt hai ka yacha madhe? Hello, this characteristics is important. We want to perform the practical of these characteristics, that is seha characteristics apla practical par perform karayche. We want to derive the same curve apla derive karayche. So while conducting the test, or it may be while performing the practical, again the procedure is same. He same procedure asel, firstly the field winding it is disconnected from the supply. Field winding it can be disconnected from the supply and it is connected to that of separately a DC source. Eka separate source la connect karayachi. After that, at a zero value of current there is a some of the induced EMF it will be present due to the residual magnetism or the residual flux, it will be present in the pole. And due to that residual magnetism, there are some of the induced EMF it will be present. After that point, if we increase the value of field current, tanantar apan jar field current chi value increase keli, then the induced EMF it will be increases, or it will gives as a linear relationship according to the equation, that is Eg is directly proportional to K phi into N. And speed apan kay karto, initially it will be make at a constant value. Speed kay karte कॉन्स्टंट वैल्यू ला काय करते फिक्स करून ठेवते. ओके, आफ्टर दैट पॉइंट द कर्व इट विल बी डेविएट्स फ्रॉम इट्स लिनियर रिलेशनशिप. हा जो काय कर्व असेल तो डेविएट होतोय त्याच्या लिनियर रिलेशनशिप कडून, बिकॉज द रिलक्टन्स इन द आयर्न कोर अँड द रिलक्टन्स इन द एअर गॅप, सो इट विल बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट. ज्यावेळेस तो रिलक्टन्स अकाउंट मध्ये टेकन घेतला जाईल, ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन इट विल बी डेविएट्स फ्रॉम इट्स लिनियर रिलेशनशिप अँड ऍट दॅट सिच्युएशन द हायर फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी इट विल बी ऑकर अँड ड्यू टू हायर फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी द रिलेटिव्ह परमिएबिलिटी ऑफ दॅट ऑफ आयर्न कोर इट विल बी डिक्रीजेस अँड द रिलक्टन्स ऑफ द आयर्न इट इज नॉट मोर टाइम निग्लिजिबल सो इट विल बी टेकन इन टू अकाउंट सो इट विल डेविएट्स फ्रॉम इट्स लिनियर रिलेशनशिप. त्याच्यामुळे त्याच्या लिनियर रिलेशनशिप पासून काय होते डेविएट होते. अँड आफ्टर द पॉइंट ऑर वन ऑफ द पॉइंट इट विल बी कम्स दॅट इज द सॅच्युरेशन पॉइंट. आफ्टर दॅट पॉइंट इफ वी अगेन इन्क्रीज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ फील्ड करंट द इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ इट इज रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट बिकॉज ऑफ द मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशन इट विल बी हॅपन. ओके, मॅग्नेटिक सॅच्युरेशन इट विल बी हॅपन. Due to the magnetic saturation, the induced EMF, it will be constant for further value of current. तिथून पुढच्या कुठल्याही व्हॅल्यूला करंटच्या induced EMF काय असेल कॉन्स्टंट असेल. ओके, सो आय थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टँड. इज देर एनी डाऊट? याच्यामध्ये कुणाला काय डाऊट आहे का? गिव्ह मी रिप्लाय.
नाही सर.
ओके, सो इन दिस वे we will conclude this today's lecture and we will stop here. Thank you.